August 2016. Astronomers discover something that could change the future of humanity. Studying Proxima Centauri, the closest star to our sun, they detect a planet orbiting around it. What's more, the planet seems Earth-like. They name it Proxima Centauri B.
Proxima Centauri B is about the mass of Earth. It looks like it's in the habitable zone of its star. I mean, how amazing is that?
It's called Proxima because it's so close. So close that NASA may already be capable of getting us there.
Hard as it may be to believe, technology for reaching Proxima Centauri B has actually existed since the 1950s. It's called a Project Orion spaceship. Basically, it's a large pogo stick that moves through space by exploding nuclear bombs behind it.
The dream of exploration is burning within us. So there are people who will find a way to get to Proxima Centauri B.
Project Orion could deliver thousands of intrepid human pioneers to the brave new world of Proxima B by the end of the century. But a 2017 NASA report reveals that when the colonists reach the surface of their new home, it will be the greatest survival challenge mankind has ever faced.
The NASA study looks at how Earth-like and habitable Proxima B might be, and it's not good news.
So Proxima Centauri B may be a habitable planet, but it's also probably a dangerous place to live, at least for us.
The greatest risk to the colonists come from their new sun. Proxima Centauri is a red dwarf, and that makes it dangerous.
Because Proxima Centauri is much smaller, much cooler than the sun, the planet around it actually needs to be a lot closer to the star in order to be in the habitable zone.
It's about 20 times closer to its host star than Earth is to the sun.
But it also means that planet gets lashed by up to 2,000 times more solar winds and cosmic rays and ultraviolet rays than our own sun does for Earth.
When the colonists stride out onto the surface of their new home planet, the sun in the sky appears large, dark, and red. A glorious sight. But it means the planet is under threat from giant solar flares. From this scorching sun, humans would have to find shelter.
Once the colonists get to Proxima B, they need to get out of the way of that radiation, and the best place to avoid that is underground.
Perhaps we'll be able to establish cities that are beneath the surface.
The colonists must build a new kind of largely subterranean civilization. On Earth, our brains and our bodies have been shaped by the environment we contend with. The landforms, the oceans, the chemical makeup of the atmosphere. Scientists believe an alien environment like Proxima B could change humans into something very different.
It's hard to imagine what it would be like to live in one of these underground colonies. What would that do to a person in their lifetime? What would that do to humans over evolutionary time?
Could a colony on Proxima Centauri B eventually produce a new species, Nova Sapiens.
Human colonists could reach Proxima B by the end of the century. To survive the intense radiation on the surface, they would have to settle underground. Under those harsh conditions, scientists believe the colonists might not stay human for long.
So one of the things that Darwin assumed was true about evolution is that it has to happen slowly. And now we know that that's not true.
If you had a separate colonist group that travels away and leaves humanity, the rest of humanity behind, they would certainly begin to evolve differently from those who were left on planet Earth.
Here on Earth, we know that populations can evolve even in just a matter of a few generations. Any changes that happen, for example, from mutations caused by all of the radiation exposure, will make them different in a much faster rate than what we'd have here on Earth.
The planet's higher mass, 1.3 times that of the Earth, would have the most immediate effect.
What we might see is that people become adapted to a higher gravity environment, for example, by having stronger bones and stronger muscles.
the colonists' subterranean existence may have an even more dramatic effect on their evolution.
Away from the light, most likely they're going to be very pale in complexion. Goodbye, vacation tan, because you're not affected by the rays of the sun anymore.
On Earth, organisms that live in low-light conditions, like those that are nocturnal, often have very large eyes. So would humans evolve to have larger eyes if we're living in relatively low-light conditions underground?
These mole people, if you will be pale and huge eyes. Maybe even their other senses would adapt to this dark environment. It could also really harden the colonists and create an environment where you must literally struggle to survive. A very competitive environment.
This competitive environment would push natural selection into overdrive. The human colonists of Proxima B could soon evolve into a new species, the mole-like Nova sapiens. But meanwhile, on Earth, the humans who stayed behind would be going through an evolution of their own.
Studies have already shown that we're seeing changes in our jaw structure, for example. They're getting smaller. We're eating more processed food. We're not crunching down on grains or breaking open bones and eating marrow. We're eating Snickers bars. Another change we're seeing in our own human physiology is our heads are getting smaller. Buy a hat lately? You might not need an XL anymore. It's because our brains are becoming more efficient.
The Earthlings of the future will use their highly efficient brains to interact with ever more sophisticated technologies.
As we move forward and we become a more technologically advanced society, the traits that allow us to interface with that technology will be the ones that are highly prized. Whereas traits that allow us to, say, be really good at lifting rocks or hunting for things will diminish.
On Proxima B, the Nova sapiens are hardened by the extreme challenges of their planet. Pictures of Earth beamed through space give them a tantalizing glimpse of what their ancestors left behind.
There would definitely be Proxima B colonists who would see the grass as greener on Earth, partly because they would not have grass, but also because of the freedom of resources, just the wealth of our planet.